Good evening. I'm going to call the CRA meeting to order at 6:30. We're going to begin tonight's meeting with invocation by Board Member McCray, and I'll ask him to also lead us in the pledge to the flag, if you'd please rise.
Let us bow to the Creator Maker of all mankind. We come this afternoon recognizing that thou art God, and besides thee, there is no other. We ask tonight, before we speak, that you retool our tongues, that we're careful of the words that we say and how we say them. For those that will address us, we ask that you retool their tongues as well. Let us be mindful that whatever we say, in the end, we're going to have to stand and give an account. We thank you for letting us live in the USA of America, the greatest country in the world. All these blessings we ask, why? Because you live. In your name we pray. Amen. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Board Member McCray. Can we have a roll call, please? Present.
Present.
Yes.
Present.
Here.
Thank you. We have a quorum. No legal agenda approval. Is there any changes to the agenda? I would like to make one change. We have for under new business item F and G, I'd like to move them up to the front of new business. We have a person here in case we have any questions, and they have family from out of town, and they'd like to, I guess, get back home to them. So if nobody has a problem, we'll hear those two first under new business. Anybody else have any changes?
Motion to approve as amended.
Second.
I have a motion, second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All opposed? So the motion unanimous. Information items and disclosures by the board member and city our staff. I'll start with Board Member Fitzpatrick.
I like to go last. I got to find something.
Okay. Board Member Casello?
Just a couple of things. I participated, first of all, I attended the advisory board, the CRA advisory board meeting the other night. Very impressed how it was run, the professionalism, the questions that were asked. I think we're on to something really good here. Also, Sunday, we marched with some of the commissioners here. Souls to the polls. The heart of Boynton rallied to bring people to the polls. And the other day, I was we went to the Forum Club with the city manager up in the convention center in West Palm Beach, and we had some great speakers up there, and basically they were talking about the national debt and where it's taken us and where it's leading us. So it was a great, great discussion and very informative. Thank you.
Board Member Merker.
Yours truly also was at Souls to the Polls. The leadership, I think, is excellent. People need to realize that voting is the greatest privilege that we have as a citizen of the United States. And to be negative is foolish. And the leaders of the Souls to the Polls, I applaud them. Number two, what I'd like to do is, as I look at all the CRA employees, Election Day is this coming Tuesday, and I've had the privilege and honor to work with them and to learn a little from them. And I want to thank you for your time and effort that you've given me personally.
Mr. McCray, Board Member McCray.
Thank you, sir. Saturday, I did a 5K run. Don't ask me why. Sunday, I was able to march with the group Souls to the Polls. I had no idea that so many things could ache when you get a certain age, but I'm over it now. I did not vote on Sunday, but I did. My mom and I, we did go today, and we voted. And I tell everyone that's sitting out there, please take advantage of the early voting. It was an easy walk-in, easy vote, walked out. And who I voted for, that's between and I. Thank you.
About 2 weeks ago, I was invited to put on a hard hat and tour the construction over at the 500 development that's going on, and it was very informative. They're very anxious. If you can remember, a couple weeks back, we had quite a bit of rain, put them a couple days behind, but they're working really hard to make up that time. They also ran into some unexpected difficulties on 4th Street. They ran into a big bunch of AT&T lines that nobody knew were there. They had to work around that, but they're very energetic. They put a lot of people on the crew there working, so it's coming along, and they expect to make up any time that they had lost, so that's going along well. Then on Wednesday, I believe it was, I got to read to the kindergarten at Freedom Shores Elementary, because it was the read the whole thing, and I believe our vice mayor also read there. And then lastly, got to tour the East Water Treatment Plant, which is undergoing revitalization. It's a tremendous project. You may have noticed they've already built another big water storage tank that can hold 3 million gallons. Our tower that everybody sees that looks like the martini glass holds 1.5 million gallons. This new vat is going to hold 3 million additional gallons, and that they can produce, when they're all finished, we're going to be able to produce over 24 million gallons of water at any one time if we had to. And they're also running the line. If you see the down Woolbright, you see the big line. That's connecting our west plant to our east plant. This is going to, when we get through with all this, two things it's going to do. It'll provide any water we would require for any new development in our downtown area. We won't have a problem there. It's already planned ahead of time. And we will fulfill our needs to the year 2050, according to our utilities director. He said this is going to carry us. So we're not. So it's a tremendously looking ahead project, I think, is I really want to commend our staff and all the people in the utilities that and the planners that have done this. It's a great job. Mr. Fitzpatrick, you ready now?
Yeah, I'm ready now. As you know, this is campaign season, and over the weekend, this came out from candidate James Brake, who I wish he was here because he should be if he's running for the city commission. And what it says is, Fitzpatrick, the only commissioner to vote for sober homes. And a list on the ethics, election code violations and penalties, it says any candidate who in a primary election or other election with actual malice makes or causes to be made any statement about an opposing candidate which is false is guilty of a violation of this code and subject to fine. Well, he's false on this, and we can prove he's false because this is in reference to actually the Novus Medical Office, which was the facility out by Hunter's Run, which the commission voted down 1-4 on November 17th. However, the reason we can prove that he's knowingly lie about it is at that time, James Brake was a member of the P&D board, and on October 27th, the P&D board heard heard Michael Weiner explain the project and listened intently and then voted 7-0 to approve it. So not only is he lying, he's a hypocrite. So like I said, I'm going to be filing an election violation on this. That's it.
Okay.
Mr. Chair, before we move on, yes. I'd like to say, too, I attended the water treatment plant under construction. But what is amazing with me is I can hardly wait for that big thing that looks like a worm on Boynton Beach Boulevard. I can hardly wait for the drilling to take place for them to pull it under I-95 and under the train tracks. I'm about as excited as the individuals that will be doing that. So when they do that within 2 weeks, I do hope I'll be standing there. And when they finish, I hope I'll still be standing there. Thank you.
Good point. CR Director, did you have anything you wanted to add?
I also toured 500 Ocean. I toured it today with Tom Hayden. And contractor, it was it's coming a long way. I mean, I'm surprised because it's some of it's internal into the project, so you can't see it from the street. So they're making a lot of progress, and I'm excited. It's coming along a lot faster than I thought, so I'm very excited. I can't wait to see people in there. So. It's exciting.
Amen to that, yes.
Perhaps after the election, they might open it up for the rest of the commission that's sitting up here, the board members, that we can get a tour as well. I wasn't offered one. Perhaps if I was, I would have attended.
Well, let me tell you, when I got back, I had to wash my feet in the sink because I wasn't prepared. Tom came into town unexpectedly, so I didn't have my work boots. So it's you have to be prepared because it's not user-friendly right now. It is a very, very, let's say, construction site. There is no easy way to get around.
All right, I will go hard-headed sneakers when I go. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, I'm sure he'd be more than happy to take you through.
Thank you.
He will. He'd love to.
Yeah. Okay, that's it. Okay, then we'll go for informational announcements. Turn it over to staff.
Good evening. Christopher Burdick, Special Events Coordinator for the Boynton Beach CRA. On Friday, February 19th, 2016, we had the Boynton Beach CRA presented Music on the Rocks, and we had the Funkabilly Playboys. It was highly successful. We had, again, partnered with the Food Truck Invasion, and they had 6 food trucks there. There's free parking on site. The event takes place at the Ocean Avenue Amphitheater from 6 to 9. We had about 500 guests this month, which was really wonderful. Our next event takes place on March 18th, also from 6 to 9. And then our following Music on the Rock dates are April 15th, May 20th, and June 17th. Now, we also just had Movies in the Park. And that was March 4th, 2016. The movie that we featured was E.T. the Extraterrestrial, and the event took place from 7 to 9. Guests were encouraged to bring beach chairs and blankets. Free parking was available on site. We, as always, shown a trailer of CRA district businesses, and they donated gift cards that we had a drawing. We had a drawing for the gift cards and Pirate Fest souvenirs after the film was over. Food, snacks, and beverages were available for purchase from vendors, local vendors. We had about 120 people this month. Next month, we're showing Ghostbusters. The movie times change because of daylight savings to 8 o'clock. Ghostbusters is April 1st. And then the next two movies are May 6th, when we're showing Labyrinth, and June 3rd is Beetlejuice. And this Friday, on March 11th, the Boynton Beach CRA will present the second annual Boynton Beach Blarney Bash in celebration of St. Patrick's Day. The free event will take place at the Ocean Avenue Amphitheater and along Ocean Avenue from First Street to the front of the Civic Center from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. Entertainment will include Fire in the Kitchen, Clockwork Knotwork, and Blues Dragon. We'll have vendors, retail vendors, that line up along Ocean Avenue along with kids' activities, like face painters, balloon artists. We'll have a super slide, a rock climbing wall, and a bounce house. We'll also have a wearing of the green contest, and there'll be 3 prizes, cash prizes awarded. Food and drink, as always, will be available for purchase from KP Concessions and Carefree Catering. There'll be free parking available, as always, as well. We hope to see you there.
Thank you. Any questions on the board?
I had a question, but I do have a comment, and that is in regards to Movies in the Park, although I'd be working at that time, but I do attend the Senior Center daily, Monday through Friday, from 11 to anytime I finish eating. And I just want to compliment you all, because when I'm there, they do speak about Movies in the Park. So what you all are doing is not going unnoticed. I want to let you know it.
Thank you very much.
Great. Thank you.
Yep.
Thank you very much for the update. Our CRA attorney likes to have a separate motion for the consent agenda. Is there a motion to approve consent agenda?
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion, second. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion unanimous. Information only. We have 3 things. I'll just see if you have any questions. The public comment log, there was no comments. Marketing and business development campaign, any questions on that? It's in your backup for information. And then media regarding the Heart of Boynton Neighborhood Policing Program. If you saw, there was a really good article in the newspaper about that program and the kickoff of it. I thought it was really a very, very positive article. And I will tell you, I've already had at least 3 feedback on from people about how much they like it, and it was great. They even tell me that our policemen actually saw them playing with a couple of teenagers. They got out on the street and passed the football back and forth with some of the teenagers over there. It was really impressive. The kids really got into that the cops would stop for a moment and play football with them. So we're getting some really good feedback on that. Okay, that takes us to...
Mr. Chair, before we move on March the 12th, I was waiting for city or somebody to make mention of this. We will be having a health fair here in the city of Boynton. And I'm one of those, I'm always saying that anytime we have something good going on, we fail to publicize it. But at the senior center place every day at 11 o'clock. They're constantly announcing this, and they're saying that they even have free transportation for the seniors. So the health fair will take place on March the 12th here in Boynton.
March 12th. Thank Got you. It.
Yep.
Very good. Okay, this takes us to public comments. Anybody wish to address the board items not on the agenda may do so at this time. Just come forward to the podium, give your name and address for the record, and try to make your comments in a three-minute time period.
Hello, my name is Cindy Falco DiCarrado. I live at 316 Northwest 1st Avenue. My first time in the CRA was last session, and I heard a gentleman sharing about how Boynton Beach was established, and I just wanted to set the record straight. It wasn't from the Bahamas or the Bohemian. It was from a lady named Bertie Dewey, who have founded and purchased Boynton Beach, and I appreciate the fact that he did mention so that it would cause me to study to see how Boynton Beach did come about. And I did want to make another mention, and this is to you, Commissioner Merker. You weren't very kind in your gesture to me and my husband. We were at dinner at Cindy's one night, and I just wanted to address that. I know you're running for public office, and when you do so, don't call people names. Thank you.
Anyone else wish to address the board on items not on the agenda?
No, but I would like to make a comment on what the young lady said, and I do appreciate you for bringing that up because I read that book as well, and it is in the Boynton Beach Library. That's why I tell people not to be so quick to jump to say, you know, my family did thus and so. So we, before we move forward on a lot of things, we need to really examine the history of Boynton, and that is, thank you.
Nope, very good. Okay, we'll close public comments, go to old business. Consideration of entering into an interlocal grant agreement between the City of Boynton Beach CRA and the Solid Waste Authority of the Palm Beach County to allow the CRA Executive Director Vivian Brooks to execute an agreement on behalf of the CRA Board.
Thank you, Chair. As you know, the City and CRA worked together to write a grant to the Solid Waste Authority for their Blighted and Distressed Property Cleanup and Beautification Grant. I don't know why they made that such a long name. And basically what we're doing is we're looking to target the heart of Boynton area to do some programs that will clean it up and make it better for the citizens who live there. And there was three projects, and they did fund our request fully for $62,300. Our match that we're providing is $31,247, or 33% of the grant, the total project cost of $93,547. They forwarded us our, this is a grant between, this is an interlocal grant agreement between the Solid Waste Authority, because they are a governmental entity of the county, and between the CRA, so because they have to have one entity be the monitor of the grant, so that we are going to be the monitor of the grant. So that is what's before you tonight.
Yeah, I think... You know, staff did a great job applying for that grant and getting two-thirds of the money, and it's going to clean up some of our blight area and do some improvements to some other places that needed it. So I want to compliment you on that, thinking ahead. Is there a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Motion is second. Any other discussion?
Yeah, I just like to weigh in on that, too. Mm-hmm. I think the staff, the CRA staff, you did a great job going after those monies and being successful and doing it. It's not always an easy thing, so you should be commended for that, Ms. Brooks and your staff. Thank you.
I'd like to comment on staff as well. You know, since it is for the heart of Boynton, I'd just like to say kudos to all of you all for working so hard. I'd like to also interject at this point as well. For whatever reason it was prior, I was not meeting with Mrs. Brooks in our CRA office, but she was coming over to City Hall and meeting in the city manager's office. But starting today, I went back to meeting in the CRA office, and I told her that was yesterday. Today is a new day. Thank you.
Thank you. I have a motion and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? So the motion is unanimous. Takes us to new business, and we'll take item F first. Consideration of letter of intent from Ocean One Boynton LLC for CRA-owned property located at 222 North Federal Highway. Ms. Brooks, do you want to comment on that?
Yes, thank you, Chair. We received this letter of intent today from Bonnie Miskell. And basically, they're asking the CRA for our property at 222 North Federal Highway, which is the corner of Boynton Beach Boulevard and Federal Highway. It's a piece of property that used to be much larger and used to have a motel on it. It actually used to go to the boundary of Casa Costa, Boynton Beach Boulevard did not go through back when we bought it, and the intent of the CRA buying it was to create Boynton Beach going through and allow access to what was to be built Marina Village, and also to create the pedestrian promenade walkway. So when we bought it back in 2002. We bought it for $900,000, but then we lost a lot of the property to the public improvements, and we basically had it reappraised when Mr. Camelier, who's the principal for Ocean One Boynton, when they started coming in late last year, talking about a potential project, I had the property appraised in preparation for this day, and I sent the appraisal to them on January 11th to Ms. Miskell and Mr. Morris in order to solicit a letter of intent for that purpose to begin the process of negotiating a purchase and development agreement so we could get through the process. So basically they're asking for, well, what's where we're today is a site plan and zoning change was filed Thursday with the city for our property and a portion of Mr. Camelier's property. And it's because it includes the property, we would, as owner, we would have to sign off so the city could review it. But however, I can't sign off, I need board authority, but board authority can't be given until we go through the state statute, Florida State Statute 163, blah, blah. I'll just say blah, blah, I don't know. So we have to go through that process, and we've been through it a couple times with Family Dollar, Ocean Breeze East, and MLK South, which is where we obtain a letter of intent that they are desiring of our property. We do a 30-day notice of intent to dispose of the property, and then we have to, if we're going to sell it below market value, which in some cases we do, in some cases we don't, then we have to put it on city commission for the approval. That is the state statute process. So that's what we have to do in this case. So we did receive it today. The current value, the appraised value of the property, now that it's much smaller, is $460,000. The land use on the property is mixed use core, and now it's just shy of half an acre. They're looking at to do a mixed use project on this. Our land and their land. And so right now what staff is recommending, they're asking for the land at no cost to them. And that has been discussed for many, many, many years. That's not been any surprise to me since I've been here. That's been part of the plan all along. So staff is recommending that we believe that transferring this property to Ocean One for the proposed project is the best use of our land, and we do support approving acceptance of this letter of intent by the board.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Yes.
Before we move on, I don't know if you were sitting up here or if I was sitting up here, but the reason we bought that motel for $900,000 was that, first of all, it had a lot of problems. Illegal activities was taking place, and I know some of the commissioners sitting up here said we paid too much, but I'm just saying for what was going on there, and to salvage and to save the city of Boynton, I think it was money that was well spent. Thank you.
Okay.
Question, Vivian. Regarding F versus G, F is what you said, or should I ask, regarding the transfer of the property, right?
F is the adjacent property owner's request for our property in order to develop their project.
Okay.
Similar
and B,
And G
and,
is
and G, I'm sorry.
The actual legal process okay. that we have to follow in order to
so
do
we
that.
Have two separate votes.
Yes, they are.
Okay. That's all I want.
I have a question for our director. Ms. Brooks, in regards to this property, I'm just saying if we go into this deal, I'm just saying is there any foreseeable problem, you know, where they might try to say, I'm just going to take this and then I can see if I can go come in and get a better price to get somebody else to come in and to develop what we cannot develop. I don't want to see a swap. Is there any way we could don't get locked
we
in?
We don't generally turn over ownership of our property in the purchase and development agreement. The property would not be turned over until, similar to Family Dollar, until the closing of their construction loan. It would be a simultaneous close. So there would not actually be a transference of the CRA property until that. That's what happened with Family Dollar. They didn't actually get that property until there was a project. So.
Right. Well, you know, for us, we know, but I'm just saying for the public, they don't know. I'm just saying it's good information to let the public know.
I would never recommend that you turn over property without that safeguard. Ever.
Yeah. Ms. Brooks, what's the intent of the developer on this piece of land? What are they proposing?
It's a mixed-use project, very similar to 500 Ocean.
Okay. It'll have some commercial spaces? And.
Yes, it has some commercial space. It's a preliminary submittal, so there has been, and there can't be any city comment yet, so we have to wait until we get through this process, unfortunately. So.
Thank you.
Yeah, I don't feel comfortable doing this without seeing what the property is actually going to be used for. There's nothing in the backup. It's just, you know, a couple of paragraphs. I don't feel comfortable doing this unless I know more about it.
We didn't get the plans until Friday. We picked them up Friday morning, and then we took them to Delray Blueprint this morning, and we have. In the backup, there are some elevations and not the full submittal because civil, we didn't include all that. But just to give you an idea of...
Backup that was received Thursday?
No. The plans that were submitted to the city, we went to Delray and had them shrunk down so we could make them...
I don't have that.
Yeah, you got it underneath your thing there.
No, this is my election laws.
I'm sorry.
It was emailed to you today. I'm sorry, because we didn't get the letter of intent until... Here, you can have this one to look at.
I'm supposed to look at it right now and vote on it right now. I don't think
We're not actually... Nothing will actually... Just so you understand, there will be no transaction today. There's nothing happening today. This is not a transaction. This is only starting the... first step in a transaction. And if you read the agenda cover, it really doesn't, nothing happens until we go to May 10th at our CRA meeting when we bring a purchase and development agreement that hopefully will be at in accords with the Ocean One representatives and bring it forward to you.
This principally, I'll use the jargon, is the legal ramifications so they can move forward. If things happen in between May, I'll use your timetable, then things can be adjusted. I'll use that word.
This basically starts the clock ticking so that the city can start to review the project and give them comments back. Because the project, if everything is perfect and we are in accords on the purchase and development agreement, then we'll come back to you on May 10th because the notice has to go, it has to sit for 30 days and then it has to go on the next commission. So the commission has to say the CRA can dispose of this property at below market value. Then we come back with a purchase and development agreement for you to say we're in agreement on the terms that you and Ocean One have come back to us with. And then we're done, but we have to start this first step, and by delaying it, all we do is delay the process.
Thank you.
If you want to get an idea of what they're planning there, Mr. Moss is here. I'm sure he'd be glad to tell you a brief outline of what we're looking at.
Mr. Morris is here.
Right. Just before he speaks, I'd like to make some comments. First of all, you know, to this board, we're constantly talking about, you know, we want to develop downtown Boynton, and you know, every time somebody come down with an idea or a suggestion, I'm just saying we always get to the point where we want to he and ha, and I'm in favor of go ahead and give them a letter of intent to see what they can do. I'm just saying we need to do anything we can to help individuals come down to help us jumpstart Boynton Beach on Federal Highway.
Well, I agree with you, but I think maybe if some of the other board members might be more comfortable with Mr. Moss, give them a brief outline of what they're planning.
Before Ms. Morris, can I just like to, will our newly formed advisory board be privy to this information and make recommendations, suggestions on this also?
Yes, we met on Wednesday, and the plans, I had heard they came in, or we met Thursday. I'm getting my days mixed up because we had three meetings last week. They met Thursday, and the plans had just come in Thursday to the city. So I had told them that I will bring them copies of it so they can see it, and just so they can start to look at it and start to understand what plans look like. Some people may have familiarity, and some people may not have familiarity with looking at plans. So.
But I'm also with Board Chair Acasillo. This will be a nice place for the advisory board to get their feet wet, get hand-on activity to see what really we're charging them to do. I'm just saying, to bring something back to us. I'm just saying, this would be a good learning experience for them.
Good evening.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, Boynton Beach City Commissioners. My name is Bill Morris. My address is 777 East Atlantic. Delray Beach instead of Boynton Beach, I'm a principal in the Ocean One project along with the principal owner, Mr. Davis Camilleri. I will be responsible for the all the vertical development activities. I have a fair amount of experience in South Florida, in Delray, in Boca, in Highland Beach, and I'm nearby, and I've done many projects similar to this in urban locations, and our plan, we did submit for a formal site plan approval approximately 1 week ago with the city, with all of our initial plans architecturally, traffic, civil engineering, photometrics, etc. The plan that we're looking at going forward with, and we're planning on using the same architect that did the promenade, which is now Costa Cosa. We are talking with a couple different general contractors, one of which is the contractor that built the promenade, Coastal Construction. We also are talking to Land South, among others, that's doing the excellent work across the street from us, and we think they're awfully good people. The plan calls for approximately 237 residential units, eight-story configuration, a very high quality. It'll be a rental project versus a for-sale project. I could point to a project that's similar that I completed a couple of years ago in at Second and Atlantic in Delray Beach called Worthing Place. This would be very similar to Worthing Place in character. It's basically a U-shaped building with a very large center court that will have hopefully a beautiful pool and a landscaped area, a connected garage that will be part of the project, some retail and commercial that will be at the corner of Boynton Beach Boulevard and Federal Highway, and also at the other corner, would be the south or the excuse me northeast corner at 6th and that so. All I can say is that we are very interested in being in a position to start construction, hopefully later on this, maybe late summer, early fall. We've looked at this very carefully for a long period of time, as many of you know, and we're very serious about moving forward. We have everything together. We've got certainly pieces to go. This piece of property is critical for our moving forward, and we would certainly ask for your support and working with us and working with Vivian, Ms. Brooks, I'm sorry, and that. So I'd be glad to answer any other questions, but that certainly is our plan, and we are certainly interested in moving forward quickly. We're thrilled to be here, quite frankly, and it's been a long time coming, and we're happy to be, you know, able to do this. So,
yeah, just for the information for the public, we're talking about the lot where the American Bank used to be, that thing there, and this project he's talking about would only take half of that area. that another half will still be remaining, because we're still have our fingers crossed, hoping to someday bring a hotel there. So,
well, the second half we do hope would be actually the corner piece at Ocean Avenue and Federal Highway is a hotel, and maybe the back piece or the easternmost piece be a high rise for sale product. I mean, that would be the ideal for us
in the long term. Yeah. And I'm just for the record, and I think I had already done that, Ms. Case, I had probably more than a month ago met with Mr. Morris and came here. They had shown me what their visioning of this project. So I had seen kind of what they were planning. So I want to let people know that I had met with them. Thank you.
Mr.
Any
Morris,
questions for Mr. Morris?
I have a question.
Yes, sir.
We have a project that's going in on Woolbright and the Intercoastal, and that was the group that Medicine Commission meeting because they had some concerns. And I'm just saying, if we give you our blessings to move forward with this, are you willing to meet with them to ask them if they have some concerns about the height, et cetera?
I'm not sure that I understand.
We have a group of individuals that live on the Intracoastal. Okay, they have problems sometime with the height. Okay, they appeared before us at commission meeting. They had questions. I'm just saying, if that group comes up and will have questions for you, are you willing to meet with them?
Absolutely, sure.
That's what I need to hear. Thank you, sir.
Absolutely. We'll meet with anyone, frankly.
Fitzpatrick.
So the agreement here is we give them the land?
They're asking for the land for free, yes. And quite frankly, there's nothing that the CRA can do with the land. It's the shape of the land that the way it is not really developable on its own. What we were left with after we built the Boynton Beach Boulevard extension and the sidewalk and the improvements, if you look at an aerial, which we did build, the Boynton Beach CRA did do that. So there's only a sliver of land. It's long and slender.
Yeah, I'm familiar with the property, but
it's not the value of it is 460, but the actual buildability of it is pretty slim. As far as what the downtown vision and master plan envisions is a mixed use building. You really can't do that on that small spot on that small space. So we've always envisioned that it would be part of a larger project, or hoped that it would be. And over in the last real estate run-up, we were hoping that would happen, and it didn't happen. So we're hoping it happens now, because it would actually form at least two corners of a major intersection of the downtown would actually be formulated.
Well, being part of a larger project is one thing. Giving away for free is something else. I mean, we can use this money we get for another project for other things, so I don't really see that. And then secondly, I don't feel comfortable, first of all, getting it right now, and then that other agreements haven't been worked out, like, you know, what would be the TIF be for this thing. I want to know those kind of details before we start giving away stuff.
Well, we're not giving it away. Again, this is only step one in a much longer process, so that, you know, all that would be negotiated and brought before you, of course. And they have not asked for any funding other than this. And quite frankly, I would not recommend that, because you have a very major project coming before you in the very near future that's going to need probably as all the money we can muster to do it. So you need to be thinking further and bigger than this project, and not that we don't appreciate this project or we want to give it its due, but I think rather than tie up CRA money for 10 years in an agreement, I'd rather give this property and do it that way. We could maybe get cash for it, but I'm not sure that Mr. Camelier, when he bought that property, he bought it at the height of the market, and I know that, unfortunately, it's still not, he has not recognized the value of it as of yet because of the market correction, the steep market correction. So I understand, and so I have no issue based on those numerical facts making this putting this into this project to making it work. I wouldn't recommend putting any more into it, but because of what's coming down the pike for this city and how we're going to be asked to partner with the city financially.
I realize there's more steps before we actually give it away, but my observation is the more we move down a route before doing the hard negotiations, the weaker the city's bargaining position is. So I'm not in favor of just flying off and giving something away right from the start without finding out what the final outcome is going to be.
Any other questions?
My concern is that this is only a letter of intent, okay, and I'm going to be one of those sitting commissioners be up here until 2017. And I don't have a problem with giving them a letter of intent to see what they can bring back to us by May 10th, 2016.
Is there a motion?
Go ahead. Yeah, I would like to concur with Commissioner McRae. I think obviously we look at things financially, but running of a city often is psychological too, which hopefully will encourage other developers to come forward where they see a major project like this moving forward. And as our director, our CRA director said, there's steps that have to be taken before it's completed and totally approved. So I concur, I agree that we should move forward. And it's all right, go on.
Is there a motion on item F, consideration of letter of intent from Ocean
so
1?
So moved.
I'm going to offer that motion of a letter of intent.
He just moved it.
He moved it. Well, I'm going to second it.
Sure, go ahead.
I'm sorry, I didn't see it on the agenda. So this is for a 10-story building, you said?
No, he did
eight,
not.
Eight-story building
can
for
we,
241 units.
I'm sorry
units.
To interrupt you. Can we have your name?
I'm sorry. Stephen Grant, Northeast 3rd Avenue. I live in the CRA. And my, I guess the main question is, has there been a traffic study for the additional units, for the additional commercial that plan is happening?
We've done a preliminary traffic study, not a full one yet.
Okay.
Has not been requested, but okay. We certainly will.
And do you plan on having a community benefits agreement? Because you are asking for $460,000 worth of land for free. Would you be willing to hire local residents of Boynton Beach?
Of course, sure.
Okay. And those are my two main questions, that the traffic is issued and that you'll be hiring local residents of Boynton Beach. Thank you.
It's a no-brainer.
I have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Nay.
Show the motion passes 4-1.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Item G is consideration of publication of a notice of intent to dispose of real property, CRA-owned property located at 22 North Federal Highway. This is a companion. I have a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Move second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Nay.
Show the motion passes 4-1. Takes us back to item A, consideration of interlocal agreement between the City of Boynton Beach and the CRA for the property maintenance of the Northeast 4th Street parking lot.
Good evening, Board Chair, CRA Board members. Mike Simon, Assistant Director with the CRA. The item before you is approval for the interlocal agreement between the City of Boynton Beach and the CRA to perform maintenance on the newly completed Northeast 4th Street parking lot. The property is owned by the city, and if we're going to expend dollars for maintenance, we need to assure that we have a interlocal agreement outlining the relationship between the CRA and the city.
Right. Is there a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Moves a second. Any discussion?
Yeah.
What is this going to cost us?
Mike, I think we had this discussion before in the on this parking lot, as far as I think I've asked that question about the cost of the maintenance, and we got native plants there, and it's going to be very minimum, the maintenance.
Yes, sir. The bids we have already for this year annually are about $6,700. There's a lot of trash pickup in addition to the regular maintenance, the fertilization, and all that other, the other typical and customary maintenance that we do on all the properties that we own. The city doesn't have it budgeted. Certainly, that's something that the CRA board can decide, whether to do this for a year, whether to do it for 3 years or 2 years, until the city can absorb financially the cost of this additional capital improvement. And that's, you know, kind of in some of the dilemma between CRAs and cities when we do things like the amphitheater or we build a parking lot and turn it over to the city, they're not prepared, or the sign like we have with the new entrance signs. It's not in their budget this year to build or maintain these types of projects, which is why we can do them. If they were in their capital improvement budget statutorily, we couldn't do it. But we can build it, and if we're going to maintain it, we should protect the agency by having an interlocal agreement. Now, between the CRA board and the city commission, city manager, the director of the CRA, the length of time that which the two parties agree to absorb that cost is between the agency and the city. Staff is recommending, I believe, in this case, termination on September of 2018, September 30th. So it gets us through one full year into the next 2 years.
Almost
so
a two-year. Yeah. The CRA will take care of first 2 years.
Right. That gives the city an opportunity to plan that in. Now the agreement can be terminated within notification of both parties. So if the city decided before 2018 to budget this into their annual maintenance, let's say at the fiscal year, even this fiscal year, it could be terminated and the city begin taking over that responsibility. But we don't want to have built this thing and the city not have any maintenance money for it, and it obviously not be cared for after we did it. So it, even in the short term, we'll need this to get us through this budget year.
I still have comments, Mike.
Of course.
Seem like you're talking to one group. I'm just saying, seem like when I asked the question, you made the statement, $60 or $700. Can you tell me the exact price? Because when it came to me, it said like $60 or $700. So what is the price?
No, I said $68 or $6,700.
$6,700.
Yes, I don't know the
$6,700.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Yes,
thank
sir.
You. That's what I need to hear.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry. I wasn't clear on that.
That's to maintain it?
Yes. Yeah, you're talking about trash pickup of 3 to 4 days a week, the trimming and the blowing. These are
that's per year, right?
That's per year. Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
It's actually well within the average of all the properties we have. The Harbor Master, the Tower, the Little House. They're all very comparable.
Well, I'm in favor of the city not taking over until 2018. Give us 2 years to get it in the budget and stuff. I think that'd be good. That CRA, since you're going to build it and put it together, you could take care of it for until 2018. Be great. I have no problem with that.
Additionally, I guess I should also let you know that the contractor that won the bid for the maintenance is also the contractor that did the installation with the project. So there's extra motivation to keep the plants healthy and alive, because he'd have to replace them as per the 1 year warranty anyway. So it's added security. It's worked out good on other properties like that too.
Thank you. Any other questions?
I'm good.
I think we had a motion and a second, did we not?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Show the motion unanimous. Thank you. Consideration of approval of interlocal agreement between Boynton Beach CRA and City of Boynton Beach in regard to the Solid Waste Authority of Palm Beach County grant.
This is simply an agreement between the city and CRA for the prior ILA. I know it's confusing. It's confusing to us. Where this basically the Solid Waste Authority wants to know who's going to maintain the improvements that they're paying for.
Right.
Now, some of these are on city land, so we just need to clarify that the city's going to maintain those improvements. They're doing it already. So they're already maintaining those properties. So this is just clarification for the solid waste.
It's a companion item to the one we approved previously about the grant. Yes. Is there
motion
a motion?
To approve.
Is there a second?
Second.
Motion is second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Show the motion unanimous. Consideration of performance audit, Boynton Village LLC, The Preserve.
Susan Harris, Finance Director. This item is before you for The Preserve. Although the agreement was signed way back in 2006, it had a clause in it which it allowed the developer to defer requesting payment from the CRA until some unspecified future date. They finally came to us in June of last year with the first request, which was denied. Legal wrote them a letter, and it was denied because they did not have their performance audit performed by a CPA, an independent CPA firm. They came to us a few weeks ago with a CPA performance audit. And after evaluating it and looking at all the backup documentation, there were some issues with it. The primary issue, and just to refresh the board's memory, this agreement provides for payment based on affordable housing units, and there was an amendment to the agreement to provide for payment on affordable rental units. So after looking at the rental units, there was really no issue with that. The issue came in with the affordable housing unit. The developer said that there were 23 units that were classified as affordable. But when I investigated and looked at all the public records, out of the 23, there were actually only five that were, in 2015, still owned by the original owners that were affordable housing units. So after documenting all of this and sending all the information to the developer a week ago, the staff and legal had a conference call with the developer to explain our position, that we could not recommend to the board their payment request of $67,000, that according to our calculations, the payment should be $45,759. And so that's, the developer understood this and agreed to it. Vivian, I don't think the developer's here tonight, so they have no issue with it. So our request to you is to approve the payment. This would be the first of 10 payments. And of course, the payments would be in different amount based on the property values each year. But this will be the first of 10 payments in the amount of $45,759.
Susan, I have a question for you. Yes. I need to know, since it's going to be 10 payments and it's going to be different amounts, do you anticipate this going over $45,759?
It could. It depends on the value of the property in any particular year.
I will let you know that the majority of the units are funded, have been funded by state money, which does limit the income of the residents. So that will limit the value of the property. So I would venture to say there's not going to be a huge increase here. So,
Susan, is this something you're going to have to do every time they come in to double check their math to make sure?
Yes. I can tell you it took a tremendous amount of time. It really did. But yes, they're going to submit their, well, the rental units, as I said, are really no problem because there's a state form that they submitted to us and it's just a matter of verifying it. It's the housing units. Any address that they submit in any future years will have to be checked. If they submit 50, I have to check 50. If they submit 10, I have to check 10. It has to be checked every year, yes.
That's something we can recoup, those, I mean, obviously that costs the CRA some time and money. Is that something we can, no?
It's part of my job.
Well, you're doing a great
job. That's due diligence. We want to do that, yeah.
The preserve is, now, refresh my memory, I think because it was before I got here. Was it, that was supposed to be
market rate
housing.
For sale.
For sale. And the whole complexity down, it's all changed now. It's turned into these rental areas. Okay. All right.
Also, Susan, on that backup, it says 23 units were affordable in 2015, and now we only have five. You know, what was the reason for the shift? Anybody can tell me?
Yes. And Vivian, pipe in. In 2005, 6 and 7 and 8, these 23 units
We entered into the agreement in 2006.
Yes.
Okay.
But now, when I looked at the property records, for an example, the original owner went into either bankruptcy, foreclosure, or short sale. It was then, these units were then bought by investment firms, LLCs, LPs, or held by banks. And they still are, for the most part. A couple of them have been sold to individuals that are not affordable. You know, they didn't qualify. They weren't affordable eligible. But most of them went to investment firms to do, I don't know what happens then. Maybe they rent them out or whatever.
I have a question. If 23 units, they get a payout of $67,000, how come with only four units they still get $45,000?
Five units.
It's the percentage, the payout is based on a percentage of the eligible units. There's an exhibit at the end of each agreement that states that out of 50 affordable housing units, if they sell, or if five of them are held by affordable eligible people, then they get X percent of the payout. And the rental units, I think it was 100 would be 100 rental units that were affordable would get 100% of the TIF calculation. In this case, it was 116 out of 150, I beg your pardon. So they get, I think it was 78%. So the calculation is based on what the total payment would have been to the developer, separated out by the what the assessed values are for the housing units and what the assessed values are for the rental units, and then the percentage is applied. So there's a chart, my calculation chart is in the backup, but that's the way I calculate it out.
So this is really including rental and affordable housing, which is five units?
Yes.
That's what we need to hear. Okay. I'm good.
Yes. Public?
Mark Carriger, 248 Main Boulevard. I want to first and foremost thank Susan Harris. Susan is a consummate professional. You guys need to be reminded of that occasionally. She does exemplary work, and her due diligence on this is to be commended. She understands the process. This was not a great agreement. There were some flaws with this agreement back in 2006 when it was executed. The board could have made it a tighter agreement, and that's one thing that would have made this a lot easier. That property has had several problems over the years, and I want to thank Susan for doing this, because had they just gone with what had been requested and not done the due diligence, you would be paying out a lot more. And so I want to thank her for that. There's not having certain dates and having it open-ended was one of the big flaws with this agreement from the get-go. But you're in it, you're committed to it, and each year, unfortunately, Susan will have to do this process for the next 10 years. And because of the postponements that they've done, they may have postponements again, because there is no end date on the thing. So I just wanted to let everybody know, thank you, Susan.
There is a date. Once they start drawing down payments, they have to continue drawing them down.
So just
thank you for your input, but I have to say, you don't have to remind me of Susan's professionalism. She's incredible. We're so happy to have her.
Thank you, everyone.
So the question I have, are you locked in for 10 years?
Yes, she is.
It's called job security.
You know, Mr. Chair.
Yes.
You know, I'd like to make a comment here. This is an item that was done when we had an independent CRA board. It was done under the direction of Mr. Henderson Tillman. I'm just saying, a lot of people come to us and say, what about the independent CRA board? What about the two people on there? Well, now we find out that was an agreement done by the independent CRA board that we are still dealing with. I'm just saying, I want to bring that out just for a point of clarification. It wasn't done by the people that are sitting here. It was done prior.
Okay. Do you need any kind of a motion on this?
Yes, I do need the board's approval of the payment.
Okay.
There's a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Show the motion unanimous.
Thank you.
Okay. Consideration of approval of the PRH Boynton Beach LLC's performance audit for year ending December 31st, 2015 for the Casa Costa project.
Yes, board. This is the sixth year of a 10-year agreement, and the payment amount, they did meet the requirements of their performance audit, and the payment amount this year is $539,578, and it's up from last year because the assessed value of the property went up in the last year's tax rolls. So we need the board approval for this payment.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Is there a second?
I'm going to second it for discussion.
Yes.
Okay, under discussion. Go ahead. Great.
Okay, I see where it says that the total remaining with the CRA is $596,376 from backup.
That is correct.
After we pay the $539,578.
That's correct.
So then that's what we have to work with prior until the end of the 10 years?
The value will change each year based on the assessed values.
So we would not be looking at paying $539+ every year?
It could go up. It could go down.
Okay. Why are we saying total remaining with the CRA? Explain that.
Okay. I'll see if I can explain. We received the $539,578 plus the portion for the CRA. The total amount that we got was $900,000, say. We pay our agreement with the developers to pay them 47.5% of whatever the CRA receives. So that's the calculation for that. That 47.5% equals the $539 plus $100,000.
I hate to say, tell you to repeat it again, but go slow again. Because
okay,
for this
fiscal year, the actual tax increment funding that was created by this project was $1,135,954. And then the amount that goes to related is 47.5% of that is $539,578. And then what we keep, which is in our budget already, we've already budgeted, is $596,376. So that's each year, those numbers will vary based on what the tax the property appraiser says the units are worth. So those two, that number, TIF revenue created by project, that number is going to vary, and also it'll vary by what the millage is, either by the county or the city.
Okay, so that's the part I need to have explained so that the audience will get it. We get over $1 million, and we only giving back like about $539,000. Yes. That's what I need the audience
and
to get.
Also, this is the sixth year of our 10-year agreement.
Right, right. Okay. I'm ready.
If I may, Susan, I think last year, I think it was like we gave him like $487,000. Was somewhere in that.
Correct.
Somewhere in that vicinity. And this is a 10-year deal. And until recently, those storefronts were empty. I think just recently, they just got two new tenants in there. This is the sixth year. It took them 6 years to get those. We're giving them almost $500,000 for the last 6 years. I talked to Ms. Brooks and to the lawyer, Tara, on this. I think that we've got to tighten up our agreements, and I think Mr. Karajaj said it a little bit, talked about it a little earlier, to set the bar a little higher, just to say, you know, I'm all for different. I think that's, we need to do that. I understand that part of it. But it doesn't seem that the developers had the incentive to go forward to keep their end of the bargain as far as getting clients and businesses into the area, which was this diff money was supposed to do, to help promote. So I'd like to have at some point down the line discussion that we set the bar a little higher with the incentives that they benchmarks in these agreements where they have to do X, Y, and Z to receive that. It's not going to be automatic anymore. I think that's a discussion we can have. Also, as I understand it, if this property was sold tomorrow, this diff would go with the new buyer of the property. I don't believe that they should travel. I think they stay, and I think that the new buyer can come back into the CRA board and renegotiate. I think that's how it should be done. I don't think anything should be automatic when we're talking $500,000 a year for 10 years. So that's some of the discussion I'd like to have in the future. Maybe we can start on that earlier than later as we develop.
Thank you.
Any other questions on this item? Okay. I had a motion and a second, I believe. It was just need a discussion. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All opposed? So the motion is unanimous.
Thank you.
Okay. Consideration of a purchase agreement between the CRA and David Hargrove for the property located at 146 Northwest 11th Avenue as part of the Model Block Project. Is there a motion?
Second.
Most second. Any discussion?
I just have one quick question. I know it's $200K. That's fine. I think the property valued at about $185,000, $186,000, what it was. That's great. We have any idea what the closing costs and legal fees are? Those are always like a surprise.
I think Susan calculated those out at about $3,000.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Thank you.
I'm just thrilled to see this come through because we didn't think we were going to get this property. We thought we'd get maybe a piece to do the road.
Right.
And we didn't think they were being a willing seller. So Great work, Chair. Again, absolutely. By staff. I'm
Which
glad
was going to be
able,
about half, really half been, of what we paid for the
yeah,
property.
Yeah, really help us on our model block program. Go ahead. Fantastic. We get rid of some places that aren't looking too great.
Right. Thank you. I'd also like to give comments to staff. I want to personally tell you all thank you since I represent that district. And I do know where that property is. Ever since it has been there, it's been really more than an eyesore. It has been a haven for things that we would call less than desirable. That's why I'm glad to know that we're getting this property to clean up District 2. Thank you.
Thank
and
you.
And we'll be able to do two houses on yes. this property. So.
Okay, I believe I have a motion and a second on that. And all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All opposed? Motion is unanimous.
Great. Thank you.
It takes us to the Executive Director's Report, CRA Advisory Board packet that was in the backup. Any questions on that? Recap of the CRA Consolidation Workshop held 3/20/2016.
Excuse me.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Thank you. I need to go back to the CRA Advisory Board package for 3/3/16.
Yes.
I just like to say, you know, people think that, you know, when we created this board that they have not been given things to do, they have not been working, but I do think they have been going through due diligence, and I want to thank the CRA director for putting them through like a strenuous, you know, one-on-one learning system, and after this year they're going to be going to finance, so there's a lot of hard work down the road. I'm just saying, job well done.
Thank you.
Thank you. Recap of CRA Plan Consolidation Workshop 3/2/16. Any questions on that? That was in your backup, too.
I'd just like to say, Mr. Mayor, Board Chair, I should say, I attended at the workshop, and it was pretty well attended.
It was 42 people, I think,
yeah,
signed up.
Yeah, it was pretty impressive, and people were actually putting input. You had those little clickers there, which was great. It was an interesting meeting, very informative, and I think the public got a lot out of it. And I'd just like to say, Ms. Brooks, she had the, I was the night before was the advisory board meeting, and the next night you were there for the workshop, or vice versa. Yeah. So two nights in a row. So I commend you for getting out there and getting the word out.
You know, we got a lot on our plate, but I got to tell you this, there's so many good things happening in the city, and I think it's an exciting time for the city, and I think you're going to just stay tuned because more good stuff's coming.
I wasn't able to make the workshop, but I do want to say thank you for the backup. It did get me back up to speed. Job well done.
Just to keep that, I think that's it, and just before we close, I'd like to at least advise the board so they know at the last commission meeting, there was a big group of people here concerning the possible development of the old Winn-Dixie property, and I had suggested that maybe the developer would come up and meet with them. I contacted him and put him in contact with them. They're more than willing. They said they would actually, they called me, they heard about our meeting, said we heard about what you guys just suggested, and we'd love to do that. So that's in the process now. They're trying to find a date to come and meet. Anything else come before the board? Not? Stand adjourned.